for this, we're going to use Create React App. So Create React App is it's an application generator that Facebook have produced it as a way to quickly get started in bootstrapping a TypeScript application, or sorry, a React application. So if you haven't checked it out, it's at create-react-app.dev. And this is just a node package that we can install. What's really great about this is that we can use it with TypeScript very easily, and they have docs that will show us how to do that. So the way that we do this is we can use NPM or Yarn, depending on what your preference of package manager is. I prefer NPM, so we're going to be using NPM for this. And we use that with the NPX. So this is just going to execute that, that generate our application. We'll give it a name, and then we can specify a template, and that template being TypeScript. The reason that we have this template flag is that if you wanted to use something like Flow, which is another approach to doing type safe JavaScript, Flow was developed by Facebook for their internal stuff, but a lot more projects seem to be going down the direction of TypeScript than they are with Flow. So that's why I'm definitely more of a fan of it. But we're going to generate an application using this. So let's jump over to my terminal again, and we'll go create React app, and we'll do it in the current directory, and we'll do the template as TypeScript. So this is going to spin up just a really basic application, but it's also going to stand up a bunch of what React, or at least the React community has agreed upon in terms of defaults. So things like linting tools and linting rules. So what are we going to be using to ensure code style and formatting and things like that? We got to install the package because I haven't got it on my machine at the moment. Yeah. And just while we were having that chat there, I went over and checked, and the template has now downloaded. So Yay. This is the Create React app that's been scaffolded up using the TypeScript template.
Okay.
We see in the sidebar on the right, we have a bunch of files. We have our app.tsx. We have an index.tsx, which is where the application entry point is. We even have some tests, but they're also written in TypeScript so that we can get type safe information inside of our tests. And this is using a testing library called testing library with its React support. And we can see what is it doing in it, and we get IntelliSense support through that. But we won't worry about tests too much. We'll just look at the application itself. So this is our basic application that's been scaffolded up. And if I was to pop the terminal and we'll do npm start, run that up. We get our, it should pop. Yep, there we go. It's popped into the browser. Yep, there we go. Our React application is working. It's ready to ship to production because that's as complex as the application needs to be. but let's go with the canonical example and build a counter component. So we'll create a component, and I'm going to do this as a function component. So we'll call that counter. And then this is just going to return a, we'll do a div, and inside of that we'll go a p tag, and the count is going to be count.
And for anybody who's not familiar, count. You'll notice here that he's literally able to just put that HTML right in with his JavaScript. So the peanut butter and the chocolate coming together.
As I was saying before I dropped off, we're building a counter application. And for those of you that aren't familiar with React, the TSX or JSX syntax allows us to build, to use angle brackets with inside of our JavaScript. So we could put like div tags and p tags or our own custom components and so on and so forth. And we could put them in here. And then React, when it runs, will generate those out to be valid method calls against the React API to in turn make our UI appear.
Okay.
But yes, we've started building out a counter component. But as we'll see as we're trying to use this, we have a little red squiggly. And that's because it's going, well, you've said you wanted a thing called count to appear here, but you haven't told me what that is, right? Okay, well, that's because it's a prop that I want to pass in. So let's use, so we could, so this will come in as the first argument called props, or I would call it props, Well, we're going to just deconstruct that here. Great, cool. So we've now told the application where count's coming from, but TypeScript is still like, well, hang on a sec. It might be coming from there, but I still don't know what it is. If we have a look at the error message itself, it's saying that this is implied to be an any type. So an any is just TypeScript's way of going and throwing its hands up in the air going, I've got no idea what you're trying to do here. It could be a number, it could be a string, it could be an object, it could be a function, it could be anything. So maybe you want to help me out here and give us some information about what this actually is going to be. What is that argument looking like? What's that shape of it? And what are the types of the properties available within it? The reason that it does that is that, well, we have this rule turned on that says that we're not allowed to have implicit anys. So this is something that's turned on in our TypeScript config, and it's one of the rules that the TypeScript sets by default in the compiler, because you want to try and avoid using any in your application, because the more anys that you have, the less value TypeScript can give you, because you're basically telling TypeScript, ignore this, ignore this, ignore this, ignore this. And the more you do that, well, then you start questioning what value is it going to be bringing. So we'll go ahead and define an object shape for that. So this will be called count, and that's going to be a number. And what I've done is I've put a colon here, which indicates that, so this is then how we would do a type annotation of an object in JavaScript. In TypeScript. So I'm annotating it with a type, which is just an inline anonymous type here, and that count is going to be a number. So now if I hover over count, it knows that it's a number. And then here, count is a number. Excellent. So let's go and add this component to our application.
And you also could have created an interface out of that if you had wanted to be able to level that up and maybe share that out with something else if that was what you wanted to do.
Yep.
Look at that.
Yeah. And in VS Code, you'll see I've got this little light bulb that's just popped over here. So when I highlight that that anonymous type, and then if I do control dot, which activates that code tip, it says, do I want to extract that as a type alias or as an interface? So I can do that. And then let's call this counter props. There we go. And then that's, so we could extract that out, and then you could, so if you were sharing these across multiple files, then maybe we'd extract that out, and then you could have that interface as something you could use elsewhere.
Love it.
So I'm just going to delete out the boilerplate code that's here, and we're going to put our counter in place. Counter. Awesome. So I've put it in place, but hang on a sec. Now we've got another red error, and it's telling us that the property count is missing because we're not passing any props to that component. So this is a game where if we're doing a shared component design in React, which is the most common way that you would build React components, maybe I didn't realize that I needed to pass a default value for count here. Maybe I thought the count was always going to be managed by the counter itself. It's like, well, no, hang on a sec. You need to pass a value in here. So count will be, let's go, hello. And lo and behold, we get an error message because, oops. First off, counter is not what I called it. So it's going to tell us that, well, the property that I've given it, counter, doesn't match anything that's expected. At the count, we'll now get an error saying, well, you've given us a string, but I expect a number here. So again, TypeScript is just making sure that I don't do, I could have zero, it's come in from an API call and that it's a string, but so I've just passed it in. It's going, well, hang on a sec, now you've given me a string, but I really just wanted a number. So finally, we'll put zero there, save that, we'll come back through the browser, and we get our value as we expect. So let's go ahead and have a look at how we can make that value change using React hooks and see what we can do with TypeScript and React hooks. So I need to import the React hooks. We'll put in use state. So React hooks, again, we talked about this last time we did a React session, but it's a way of managing state with inside of a function component, because a function component doesn't have state of its own, but we can use the React hooks APIs to set that up. So we'll create some state, and we'll have the count and set count, and then use state. If we have a look over here in the type signature that's just popping a little bit behind my head, actually, if I do that, now it's not behind my head. We'll see that use state can take a generic argument. I'll expand that a bit further. It could take a generic argument, which is going to be S. That's just the label that they've given it in the type definition. And then that can be the initial state or a function that will return initial state. And then that generic argument is going to be returned as the first value of the deconstructed array. And then we'll have a function that will modify that. So if I just do nothing, we'll see that count is, well, it's undefined. It doesn't have a value associated with it. If I was to use the generic argument, I could say, let's click here, we go number. Now we know that count will be a number, or it could be undefined because we've not given it a default value. If I give it a default value of 0, count is now only ever going to be a number because we've initialized it, and I can remove my generic argument. So count is now, it knows that it's a number because it's inferred from 0 being a numerical value. It's inferred that that's the type. And set count will be an updater function that takes a number to update the count value. So now instead of passing this here, I can pass in count. That cascades through all correctly. And our UI still respects what we are expecting and works the way that we want it to work. So we could then add, say, a button and then have that being a plus symbol. And then we'll create another button, which is a minus symbol for increment and decrement. And we'll add an on click, which will take, this time we'll give it 0 arguments because we can ignore that first argument. I don't need the event argument that's happened from that click. Instead, we're going to count. We'll set count. Count plus 1. And then we'll just copy this line of code down. Pop it here, and instead of plus 1, we'll make it minus 1. Save that. And now our counter goes up and our counter goes down. And this is all done in a type safe manner. Like we know that that count, set counter requires a number passed to it. We know that count is going to be a number. We have our external component that just so happens to be a few lines above, but it could be coming from another file. It has a prop that it expects, which is a number, and we're passing it in a number as well. And inside of that, it's getting a number and it's outputting it. It's converting it to a string so it can output it inside of that p tag. If we were to change that and just do number here as the generic argument, now we would see a bunch of errors because, well, count, it could be a number or maybe it hasn't been defined because it was never initialized. Mm-hmm. We can't pass it to our external component because it's a number or undefined, but I only want a number.
I
this is where I think TypeScript makes things so much more powerful.